द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज बिहेवियर. इट अ पर्सन और अ कंट्रीब्यूटर्स हिज हेल्पफुल बिहेवियर मेक्स हिम अ डिफरेंट पर्सनैलिटी. हिज मेन अप्रोच टूवर्ड्स लाइफ इज टू टेल टू हेल्प the other people of the society. So his behavior is normal and caring with the other people. Next point is proper planning. That a contributor has a quality to plan his work properly. For example, the company has a project and they have to complete it within 2 months. So proper planning of a team members for their work, they can easily finish the project. So if in the group there are they work in a proper manner and they work they have a proper planning for their work, then they distribute the work among the each others, and after that, after the end of the project, we can find that because of proper planning, they have successfully completed their work, their task. Self-discipline is the another qualities of the contributor. Whatever rules they have decided for themselves, they have have to follow those rules and regulations, and they live in the disciplined manner. So self-discipline is another quality of the contributor. Next one is committed. That a person is a committed towards his work. He never thinks that some other person will complete the task instead of him, because he is committed towards his work, and that's why he works very hard to finish his work. Whatever task is given to him, he's because of his commitment or his committed nature, he successfully do that task. That is his commitment towards his project. Next one is multicultural communication. That a person is a contributor, so he should have a knowledge about different languages. Whether he works in the company or he works independently, he has a knowledge of multiple languages so that he can communicate with everyone easily. At least he must know his mother tongue, his national language and international language. So when he has a knowledge about his mother tongue and international language, that is English, so in any field he can communicate easily with the people, and he can contribute to them easily when he knows a multiple languages in the society. Here is the example of a contributor and a contributorship, where you find the image of the players, and there is one person who is a coach of these players. So it's image of it's the image from the movie Chak De India, where we find that a coach, he is trying to make them aware about the game. So in the movie Chak De India is a story of coach fighting of making his team India by overcoming their diverse backgrounds. All the players of the team, they belong to a different backgrounds. They come from a different state of India. That's why their mother tongues are different, their cultures are different, their thinking and behaviors are also different. We find the struggle of the coach to make them as a one team. So they are going to represent, because they are going to represent their country, they can't behave like an individual. They must have respect and feelings for each other. Due to their diverse backgrounds, it is difficult to create a team. But coach's contribution because of codes contributory personality, he makes it a proud team of India. Because we find that there are differences and different mindset of the players, but because of the coach's hard work nature and because of coach's contributory nature, we find at the end of the movie we find that they play like a team, that is team for Team India. That it's a story about honest determination, sincerity and human spirit to find and win. When you see each player of the team, you find that all of them are honest, sincere and determined about the game, because they play for not only for himself, but they play for their country. And that's why honesty and determination and sincerity towards their game, we find it in the movie. The next thing is his contribution. What is the coach? Coach's contribution in that game? That he contributes his power, knowledge, strength to the team. That because of his knowledge, he makes a successful team for his country. He shares his knowledge and strength to the team. We find the dialogue about the 70 minute to encourage his team to perform their best in the field. It is his contribution to his team as well as his country. So he contributes his country, India also. We cannot say that he contributes to his team or to make confident players in the team, but it is the contribution for the country also. His lovingness, honesty and sincerity towards the team, that we find in the movie. When you see it, you find that how honest he is, how sincere he is towards his work. So, and because of his love for our national game, that is hockey, we also feel the respect for our national game. So we can say that all the teachers are also contributors to the society, because all the teachers, it is the duty of the teacher to make students aware about the society. They don't only give bookish knowledge to the students, but also teaches about life's lessons. And that's why we can say that all the teachers are also contributors to the society. So it is the contribution of a coach for his country. Now let's talk about the growth. So here you find that there is a chart, and in which there is different types of growth: physical growth, emotional growth, action growth, intellectual growth and spiritual growth. So physical growth is a natural process of time on the biosystem. It's a natural process. When we talk about physical growth, it's a natural process that when we see a newly born child, that his physical growth is very small, and when he grows up, at that time he is physically growing. That is a natural process of the biosystem. So with the physical growth, we find that the other growths are related. When a person is physically growing, with that the other types of growth also grows with physical growth. So the first one is intellectual growth, or we can say that mental growth. That it is the development of soft skills is based on the mental capability with the use of creative and innovative mind. That when we find a 5 years old child, his mental conditions and his intellectual growth, it is different from the 15 years old child. Obviously, because when he is growing, then his intellectual or mental growth is also growing. So whatever he learns or he acquires at the age of 5, it is different at the age of 15, right? Then next one is emotional growth. that it occurs as a person grows and strives to adjust with the expectations of the other members of the society. That we find that when he feels for the others, he has an emotion for the other people, he tries to adjust with family, with friends, he tries to adjust with the expectations of himself when he is growing. So it's emotional growth. Then spiritual growth. Then next one is spiritual growth. It shows the honor for spiritual growth and superhuman entity described as religion or God. It prompts the frankness, selfless behavior and self-imposed discipline. When we talk about spiritual growth, we can say that being a mature human being, when the person becomes mature, it is already developed in himself to be a frank and to have a selfless behavior, because instead of thinking about himself, he thinks about his family first. Then he believes in God, that is a kind of spiritual growth of the personality. And last one is action growth. It indicates one should start with good instead of delaying for a still better approach. So when he is a mature human being, so he thinks that he should start from today. When he thinks about, suppose he is thinking about contribution, so he thinks that today is the best time to contribute myself to the society, instead of thinking about that tomorrow I will work or day after tomorrow I will work. So that is action growth, that when he grows, he becomes mature, and with maturity he thinks, he acts like a mature human being, he acts like a contributory personality. So these are the approach, different growth of the human being: physical growth, intellectual growth, spiritual growth, action growth, and emotional growth.